Welcome students, this is a continuation of optics chapter. In this class we are going to learn about scattering of light. What is scattering of light? When sunlight enters the earth's atmosphere, the atoms and molecules of different gases present in the atmosphere refract the light ray in all possible directions. So see, this incident light is coming from sunlight. So when it enters the earth's atmosphere, the atoms and molecules present in the atmosphere refract this light ray in different directions. So these are scattered light. This phenomenon is known as scattering of light. Here this atoms and molecules, this particle is called as scatterer. When sunlight enters the earth's atmosphere, the atoms and the molecules of different gases present in the atmosphere refract the light in all possible directions. This is called as scattering of light. In this phenomenon, the beam of light is redirected in all directions when it interacts with a particle of medium. The interacting particle of the medium is called as scatterer. So here these atoms and molecules, these are the interacting particles. So these are known as scatterer. So next, types of scattering. When a beam of light interacts with the constituent particle of the medium, it undergoes many kinds of scattering. So based on initial and final energy of the light beam, scattering can be classified as elastic scattering and inelastic scattering. So first, what is elastic scattering? If the energy of the incident beam of light and the scattered beam of light are same, then it is called as elastic scattering. Energy of incident beam and energy of scattered beam are equal, then it is called elastic scattering. When inelastic scattering, if the energy of the incident beam of light and the scattered beam of light are not same, then it is called inelastic scattering. Energy of incident beam and energy of scattered beam are not equal, so it is called inelastic scattering. So in inelastic scattering there are four types. So based on the nature and size of the scatterer, it is classified into Rayleigh scattering, Mie scattering, Tyndall scattering and Raman scattering. So let us learn about one by one. So first one, Rayleigh scattering. The scattering of sunlight by the atoms or molecules of the gases in the earth atmosphere is known as Rayleigh scattering. So here sunlight is scattered by the atoms or molecules of the gases, so that are present in the atmosphere. So this type of scattering is known as Rayleigh scattering. So see the picture. So when the light ray coming from the sun, so it is scattered in all directions by the atoms or molecules of the gases in the earth's atmosphere. So Rayleigh scattering law. Rayleigh scattering law states that the amount of scattering of light is inversely proportional to the fourth power of its wavelength. So consider the amount of scattering be S. So the amount of scattering of light is inversely proportional to the fourth power of its wavelength. So here the wavelength is lambda. This is known as Rayleigh scattering law. Next, according to this law, the shorter wavelength colors are scattered much more than the longer wavelength colors. So we know that there are seven visible colors. So shorter wavelength, violet blue has the shorter wavelength, so red has the longer wavelength. So according to this Rayleigh scattering law, the shorter wavelength colors are scattered more than the longer wavelength colors. So when sunlight passes through the atmosphere, the blue color, that is shorter wavelength, is scattered to a greater extent than the red color. So this scattering causes the sky to appear in blue color. So why the sky is blue? Because the shorter wavelength blue color is scattered more compared to the longer wavelength color. So the color which has longer wavelength scattered less. So the sky is blue. At sunrise and sunset, the light rays from the sun have to travel a larger distance in the atmosphere than at noon. Hence, most of the blue lights are scattered away and only the red light which gets least scattered reaches us. So, therefore, the color of the sun is red at sunrise and sunset. Next type of scattering is mean scattering. Mean scattering takes place when the diameter of the scatterer is similar to or larger than the wavelength of the incident light. So we know that what are scatterer? The interacting particle of the medium is called scatterer. So mean scattering takes place when the diameter of the scatterer is similar to or larger than the wavelength of the incident light. It is also an elastic scattering. The amount of scattering is independent of wavelength. So, causes of mean scattering. Mean scattering is caused by pollen, dust, smoke, water droplets, and other particles in the lower portion of the atmosphere. So, mean scattering is responsible for the white appearance of the clouds. So when white light falls on the water drop, all the colors are equally scattered, which together form the white light. So mean scattering is responsible for the white appearance of the clouds because all the colors are equally scattered, so which together form the white light. Next one is Tyndall scattering. The scattering of light rays by the colloidal particles in the colloidal solution is called Tyndall scattering or Tyndall effect. When a beam of sunlight enters into a dusty room through a window, then its path becomes visible to us. So this is because the tiny dust particles present in the air of the room scatter the beam of light. So this is an example of Tyndall scattering. So the tiny dust particles present in the room scatter the beam light. So this picture represents the Tyndall effect in the colloidal solution. So the path of the light is visible through the colloidal solution. So next one is Raman scattering. When a parallel beam of monochromatic light passes through a gas or liquid or transparent solid, a part of light rays are scattered. So consider this is a transparent medium. So when a parallel beam of monochromatic light passes through that medium, a part of light rays are scattered. So the scattered light contains some additional frequencies or wavelengths other than that of the incident frequency. So compared to the wavelength or frequency of incident ray, the scattered light ray has some additional frequency or wavelength. So this is known as Raman scattering or Raman effect. So Raman scattering is defined as the interaction of light ray with the particles of pure liquids or transparent solids, which leads to a change in wavelength or frequency. So here, the spectral lines having frequency equal to the incident ray frequency is called a Rayleigh line. So see, frequency of spectral line and the frequency of incident ray is equal, then it is known as Rayleigh line. And the spectral line which are having frequencies other than the incident ray frequency are called Raman lines. The lines having frequencies lower than the incident frequency is called Stokes line. and the lines having frequencies higher than the incident frequency are called anti-Stokes line. So the lines having frequency lower means it is Stokes, then higher than the incident frequency means it is anti-Stokes line. So students, hope you all understood about the scattering of light and the different types of scattering. Thank you.